The Four Agreements Part 3. In the previous two videos that I posted, we talked about the first two agreements. Always be impeccable with your words, and the second one, don't take anything personally. And if you haven't seen those videos, I will link them up in the description down below, or you can check them on my channel. The Four Agreements are written down in a book by Don Miguel Ruiz. It's a Toltec wisdom. Toltec? Toltec? What is that? Well, thousands of years ago, the Toltec were known throughout southern Mexico. And they were scientists and artists who were exploring new ideas around society, spiritual knowledge and practices of the ancient times. And Miguel Ruiz was a descendant from the Toltec Eagle Knight lineage. Cool, right? And he has shared the Toltec wisdom in books. And the Four Agreements is part of that wisdom. It's a wisdom of life. It's wisdom that helps you feel good and stand in your power. Even though it's very old already, it's like timeless. It's very, very, very powerful. And that's why it's a perfect fit for my business and my channel to talk about this in detail. I get very excited about this. And in this video, we are going to discuss the third agreement that says, don't make any assumptions. Ooh. Seems as if these agreements are getting more and more difficult every time. But wouldn't it be amazing if you could stop making assumptions? And I'll teach you how. Stay tuned! I'm Carolina Sherman and I'm a spiritual, business and mindset coach, and I'm an NLP practitioner, and I would like to welcome you to my channel where I help you and other people to speed process your growth and success by doing the internal work first. So today we are going to talk about the third agreement. Don't make any assumptions. And to grow into this agreement will be a work of changing a long-formed habit. We all have the tendency to make assumptions about just about everything. And the problem with assumptions is that we tend to believe them as truth. And we make assumptions because we have this need to justify everything, to explain and understand everything. In order to feel safe, actually, and we constantly have a gazillion questions coming up inside us. In an attempt to understand the world and everything that happens around us, you know? And there are so many things that our reasoning mind can't explain. So we make up assumptions about it. It's not important if the answer or the assumption is correct, just the fact to have an answer makes us feel safe, makes us feel okay and calm. But this is dangerous. All the drama that you have lived in your life was rooted in making assumptions and taking things personally, wasn't it? We are afraid to ask for clarification, so we make assumptions, and of course we believe we are right about the assumptions. Because in our mind, and seen from our perspective, the assumption is the only possible truth, right? We also make the assumption that everyone sees life the way that we do. We think that everyone sees life in the same way. We assume that others think the way that we think, feel the way that we feel, judge the way that we judge, and abuse the way that we abuse. So out of this assumption, we make assumptions based on this assumption. It's getting complicated, isn't it? Well, that's life. When we try to defend our assumptions and try to make the other person wrong, this just gets so tricky, and we almost always set ourselves up for failure. A lot of times we make assumptions because we don't understand something, and then we make an assumption about the meaning. But then later, when the truth comes out, the bubble of the worried cloud over our head pops, and we found out it was not what we thought it was at all. All this drama for nothing. This makes me think of this TV series that I saw a few months ago, Anne with an E. In this series, there is a character called Bash, and he is falling in love with this woman, Mary. And on a given evening, he passes by her door to say hello, and he sees through her window that Mary is hugging another man and caressing him tenderly, you know? And Bash makes the assumption of, oh no, she's got another man. And he runs away. He's so angry. He couldn't have been more off with his assumption. And to his big relief, he then later found out that a man Mary was holding in her arms was her son. Mary got a son on a very young age and already had a son that looked old enough as if he could be Mary's boyfriend or husband. And this happens all the time. We constantly make assumptions. We make assumptions that our boyfriend or husband or girlfriend knows what we are talking about or knows what we want, really. We assume that they know us well enough to know what I want him to clean the kitchen once in a while. Nope. Wrong assumption. If you want him or her to clean the kitchen, well, then you have to ask. You can't assume people will do things for you because they know you well enough. They should know. That is too much pressure on a person. You can't expect a person to constantly walk on eggshells, trying to please you, to avoid your disappointment. Ask what you want. When everybody would ask for what they want, instead of assuming the other person will magically read your mind and smell what you want, then relationships would become much more easy. Wouldn't you agree? Making assumptions is a habit that we have developed growing up. In interacting with other human beings, we have experienced lots of situations, and out of those situations that have happened in the past, we now think we have this glass ball and we are able to see the truth and the future about things we don't know anything about. We also make assumptions about ourselves. We say things like, I don't think I can do that. I assume I'm bad at that. Well, those are all assumptions. And now, how can we keep ourselves from making assumptions? It's forming a new habit of asking for clarity. Making it a new habit to ask questions instead of jumping to conclusions. Make sure the communication is clear. If you don't understand, ask. But like I said, it is a long-formed habit. It isn't transformed overnight. We have to do it step by step and with repetition, over and over and over again, catching yourself when you're making an assumption about something, and change to clear and pure communication. Use your words impeccably. Use them for creating, for giving, for sharing, and for loving. Well, you know, if you feel that you owe it to yourself to give yourself all the tools that you need to grow to the next and the highest level of your potential, and yes, that level is unlimited, then make your mark and subscribe to this channel and like this video, and I will guide you to speed process your growth. And don't forget to share this video with your friends who might find this valuable as well. And leave a comment so that we can continue this conversation in the comments. And I'll see you in the next video where we are going to talk about the fourth agreement of the four Toltec agreements. So keep on watching. See you in the next video.